What do you think are some of the most common, or what, in your experience, the most common misconceptions people have nuns about nuns? When you encounter them and they talk to you, what is it that you're like, you don't understand this?
There's so many.
I know.
Like, I would imagine one to kind of get you started, and I think this would be helpful to young women who might be watching this, is like, in order to be a nun, like, you have to have a really pure past and you can't have sinned, certainly not sexually, that sort of thing.
Yeah, that's definitely one of them. And in fact, like, to amplify that even, like, that we don't even have, like, attraction to men, mm-hmm. or that we don't want, that's a question. I mean, I talked a lot about that on our first interview, I'm sure, but like, that's a question that we often get at the end of talks, especially with teenagers. They're like, why didn't you want to get married? Or why don't you want kids? And it's like, well, absolutely, we want those things. Yeah,
still do.
You know, I really like to emphasize that the call to celibacy. You know, I heard a priest give a homily one time about how he really believes that we all have, this could get broken, this could get disordered, so I want to give that nuance first, but like, we all have a natural call to marriage, and that some have a supernatural call to celibacy. So it's not that the call to celibacy replaces the call to marriage. I think it transcends it. And so I think that's a common misconception as well, is like, if I'm not, if I'm attracted to men, then I'm clearly not called to be a nun.
Or vice versa for the young men out there who are discerning priesthood. I'm attracted to women and I want to have kids. Like, good. If you weren't, you shouldn't be a priest.
Right.
Yeah, precisely. I think that we like stop being a person, like that we assume some kind of like holy personality, and like, I no longer have likes and dislikes and I just kind of float.
Oh my gosh. Now, did you have that thought about yourself, or was there a sense in which you thought you would have to become less like you in order to be a good nun? I mean, we kind of already talked about this, right?
I think there was a sense of like,
because one of the things I love about your monastery is just how individual each of y'all are. Like, y'all are so beautiful and each of you are so different.
Thank you.
And I knew you two and I knew I liked y'all. And then I showed up at the monastery and who's that beautiful sister who has the braces? What's her
Mother name? Mother Ileana.
I love that woman. She's like really funny.
Even though she's a woman?
Even though she's a woman. Desperately funny. Like quoting Princess Bride. And oh my gosh. But I love how unique each of you are.
Yeah. And I think the evil one attacks that more than I, like, it's like the suggestion that I need to be like sister so-and-so or mother so-and-so, or like, don't you see? Like, I absolutely have fought through, I mean, I'm constantly fighting that, but that was a temptation early on, is that I need to be more like this other person in the community than myself, because she seems holier and people want to have holy conversations with her and all they want to do is laugh with me. So that and laughing is clearly unholy. And so therefore I should get rid of that. You know?
I love how honest that you are. Thank you. That's so helpful. Yeah. Yeah. I forgot the question I asked. Oh, yes, yeah. How individual y'all are.
But I think
misconceptions was
Yeah, misconceptions. Like, what's some other misconceptions? Like, whatever, just people in the world, when you're walking through the airport or going to a coffee shop, like, what kind of, I guess a lot of them probably like, what are you?
Or,
welcome all Muslims. I mean, what kind of.
That's a question we get.
Sorry, speaking us in
what
Arabic.
What are you? And like, a human being. What are you? A rude human being?
Yeah.
Do they really start speaking to you in Arabic?
I've had that happen a couple
times. That's amazing.
Yeah. I'm like, I'd like some water. It's usually like at gas stations.
And when you wear a mask, or back when we had
did you wear a black mask?
Did you look like a ninja?
Yeah. Oh, absolutely.
You would look so cool.
Yeah.
And then you'd have to put the mask on and then the head thing on. I think that's what it's called, the head thing.
The head thing. The apostle.
Typically what we do with the mask, at least this is what I would do, is I'd put the mask here and then I'd put this hand under.
Wow.
And grab the mask and put it over my ear.
And then where would you put your samurai sword?
Sword
just next to the tchotchke.
Nice,
yeah.
Nice.
Actually, it is beautiful. We've encountered people who thank us for our modesty, like Muslims who will.
That man at the airport.
It was like, thank you, you are so beautiful. Like, thank you for dressing so modestly. And it was just, that was a beautiful encounter.
It was a Muslim man at the
security
at this airport. He was like working the security or something, and he called us aside and he just said, he was like, too many people today have forgotten that modesty is a beautiful thing, and you women are
it
so
really
beautiful.
Is.
Like,
yeah.
It was very touching. Yeah.
And do you think he thought you were Muslim, or that really wasn't the point?
No.
Yeah. I think he knew. Yeah.
Thank you very much for watching that clip. Before you go, do us a favor, click like, click subscribe. And if this really meant something to you, help us out by sharing it.